Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm here at Forum Mall in Chennai. So BMW and Mini have set up a stall here in the mall. So I would like to give a big shout out to them, so because they are allowing me to review the car in the mall. So a big thank you to them. So today I have this the Mini Cooper JCW. So JCW stands for John Cooper Works. And so there are like many visual updates and the engine update as well, which I'll show you in a bit. So this is a small car, a cute compact car, around 3.8 meters long, not tall, but a big, like it has a massive wheelbase. So talking about the wheels, it has a 17 inch and John Cooper Works written over here, red brake calipers. So you get 4 piston brake calipers, black dot wheels, 205, 45R 17s. So wheels are good. The black treatment looks good and you have a disc brake as well. The car would have looked great in a white color. It's in a different dark shade. You get body cladding as well here. And blacked out door handle, red colored ORVM. John Cooper's written over here. So this is a special element here. Here you get DRLs, LED lights. John Cooper was written over here as well. Blacked out Mini logo. And yeah, so from the front it looks great, the red colored stripe as well here, and these are air intakes here as well, so that's great. Yeah, so the fuel tank capacity is 44 liters, the mileage per year is around 17 kilometer per liter. So who cares about the mileage? Well, let's open it. So let's open the boot. So 211 liters, not much, a couple of bags, and you get 60-40 split seat at the rear. Loading lip is decent, and but who cares because the boot is so small. Adjustable headrest at the rear, and so you get a warning triangle as well. So yeah, the boot is not that usable, and you get the British flag here, so decent. So you get the blacked out Mini logo here as well, and you get a reverse parking camera too, and twin function exhaust here. Those are loud rear parking sensors. So you get, as I told you, get the British flag here. So Mini written over here. Attention to detail is damn good. And you get a floating roof kind of treatment here. Car is lower, that's great. Antenna and the panoramic sunroof here. So panoramic sunroof in such a small car is great actually. And like the crowd here, like when I opened the car, people are just going in. So really I need to like, had to stop in between because people are just opening and going inside the car, so that was tough but decent. And you have, these are fake, not functional. So black stripes on the hood look great. Yeah, so let's get inside. So getting in is tough. I'm 6 feet. Let's just lock the door so that people don't come in. So you get the key here, unlock, lock, and it can directly open the boot from the key. So you get twin cup holders here, an 8-speed automatic gearbox, and you get a wireless charger here. Yep, and this is the driver armrest at the rear. It's suitable for kids, not people like me. And some space here, a manual handbrake. This is the controller, the infotainment controller. Twin cup holder, as I told you, some space here. USB here, and cigarette lighter. So these are the drive modes. You can see sport, green means sport is for sport mode and green is for efficiency driving. Traction control, auto start stop, engine start stop button. These are the AC controls. And this, the steering wheel, you get cruise control and the control for the multifunctional display. Paddle shift is here. And you get the light controls here as well. Yeah, with the intensity of the instrument cluster. So as you can see there, you get metal pedals here. Those look great. And this, you see, is a 5.5 inch unit. Yep. So let's just turn it on and show it to you. Before that, I'll just show you the glove box. So glove box is decent size, not that big. Yeah, even the car is not that big, so your glove box will be decent. So let me show you this. You get a mirror with twin lights here. And again, the mirror between lights. So for safety, this guy gets two airbags, ABS, EBD, traction control, cornering brake control, and brake assist, tire pressure monitor. Yeah, emergency braking as well. So you get auto dimming inside view of your mirror. You get lights here. Yep. And you can open the sunroof as well, but I don't want to open it. Like, too much noise will be coming. And this is a 5.5 inch unit. This is an 8.8 inch unit. This is a touchscreen which gets Apple CarPlay, not Android Auto. Yeah. So this, you can configure it by this BC button. So not much to show, like, the engine is cold or hot. The consumption. Yeah, and this 8.8 inch unit, it's okay, slick to use. So it gets navigation as well, communication, media. Let's just use the controller, it'll be much easier to use. Navigation, mini connected, notification. And you get media, communication, navigation, mini, high mini figure, and you have vehicle settings. You can set the door, key, speed warning, configure green, system settings, and then the mobile devices, language, pop-ups, software update, data privacy, driver profiles, vehicle status, driving information, onboard computer, trip computer, owner's handbook. So yeah, it's loaded with tech, and speakers too are good. Small speakers, and if you see, you get ambient lighting as well. Yep, so you get ambient lighting, and your center locking, and this thing is good. The door handle, the inside door handle, as you can see, the speedometer is marked. It's a digital one, so I've been marked till 6,000 and 7,000, so it will rev on like 6,000 or something. So here you get ambient lighting, like, you can configure it. Yeah, as you can see, it's changing. Many ambient lighting colors, so a lot of things to show. Now, talking about the engine, which has a 2-liter turbo petrol, definitely, which produces 231 horsepower and 320 newton meters of torque. So this is the highest state of tune. The earlier one, the regular Cooper S, has a 2-liter, same 2-liter turbo petrol with 192 horsepower and 280 newton meters of torque. So that car does around 0-100 in over 7 seconds. This does in 6.1 seconds due to, yeah, many changes. Like, you also have this Napa leather steering wheel, so that's good. You get sport seats and manual adjust with some Alcantara as well. So seats are comfortable, and you get sport suspension as well. So car is like, yep, yeah, on hard bumps it's tough, but overall it will be comfortable, and it's damn quick. That's the main motive of the car. Like, it's based on fully sports, like, you have a sports model of the regular Cooper S. So this is the sports model, like the JCW, John Cooper Works, as I told earlier. So, like, if anyone is interested, you can go for it. And the pricing is above 55 lakhs onward Chennai. People might seem like it's an expensive car, but I really don't think so, because people who want to buy it will buy it, and it's definitely worth it. What you're paying for, the quality, the build quality, the engine and the tech, what they offer. The only thing is the lack of the space at the rear seat. Other things are good. So if anyone is interested, you can let me know. Thank you so much. Please do like, share, comment and subscribe.